23rd July, Saint Bridget, religious, optional memoria. Born in Sweden in the year 1303, she married while still a girl and gave birth to 8 children whom she brought up in a religious spirit. She was a member of the Third Order of Saint Francis, but after the death of her husband, she decided to lead a more ascetical life, even though still in the world. Later, she founded the Bridgetine Order and went to Rome, where she became outstanding in her practice of virtue. She wrote many works describing the mystical experiences she had and went on a penitential pilgrimage to the Holy Land. She died at Rome in the year 1373. A reading from prayers attributed to Saint Bridget. A prayer to Christ the Savior. Blessed be you, my Lord Jesus Christ, who foretold your death, and who at the Last Supper miraculously consecrated your own precious body from material bread, and in memory of your most sublime passion, most charitably bestowed it on the apostles. Then by washing their feet with your holy and sacred hands, you showed your great humility in a humble manner. Honor be to you, my Lord Jesus Christ, who through fear of your passion and death shed blood instead of sweat from your innocent body. Nevertheless, you accomplished our redemption as you intended, and in such a way you showed most clearly the love which you bore the human race. Blessed be you, my Lord Jesus Christ, who were led to Caiaphas, and you, the judge of all mankind, let yourself be submitted to the judgment of Pilate. Glory be to you, my Lord Jesus Christ, for the mockery which you endured while you stood clothed in purple and crowned with sharp thorns, and because you patiently allowed your honorable face to be spat upon, your eyes to be blindfolded, and your face and body to be cruelly beaten at the sacrilegious hands of unjust men. Praise be to you, my Lord Jesus Christ, who, enduring all, allowed yourself to be bound to a pillar, to be cruelly scourged, and to be led bleeding to trial before Pilate, and to appear as the innocent lamb. Honor be to you, my Lord Jesus Christ, who, with your glorious body covered in blood, were condemned to death on the cross. In agony, you carried the cross on your sacred shoulders. You were led amidst fury to the place of your passion, and were stripped off your clothes. This was how you wished to be nailed to the wood of the cross. Everlasting honor be to you, Lord Jesus Christ, who in such extremity humbly looked with fond love on your holy mother, who never sinned nor ever countenanced even the smallest sin. You consoled her and entrusted her to the faithful care of your disciple. Eternal blessing be to you, my Lord Jesus Christ, who in the agony of death granted hope of pardon to all sinners when you mercifully promised the glory of paradise to the thief who turned to you. Eternal praise be to you, my Lord Jesus Christ, for each hour you endured such great sorrows and extremities on the cross for us sinners. The violent pain of your wounds penetrated your blessed mind and cruelly pierced your most sacred heart until it broke, and you happily gave up your spirit. With head bowed, you humbly entrusted yourself to the hands of God your Father, and your body hung cold in death. Blessed be you, my Lord Jesus Christ, who by your precious blood and most holy death redeemed souls and mercifully led them from exile into eternal life. Blessed be you, my Lord Jesus Christ, who for our salvation allowed your heart and your side to be pierced by a lance, and also in that from your side you poured forth your precious blood together with water, that you might redeem us. Glory be to you, my Lord Jesus Christ. It was your will that your blessed body be taken down from the cross by your friends and laid in the arms of your sorrowful mother, and that it be wrapped in cloth and buried in the tomb. There you allowed it to be guarded by soldiers. Everlasting honor be to you, my Lord Jesus Christ, who on the third day arose from the dead and showed yourself living to those you chose. Again, after 40 days, in the presence of many witnesses, you ascended into heaven, and there you established in due honor the friends whom you had freed from the underworld. May rejoicing and eternal praise be to you, Lord Jesus Christ, who sent the Holy Spirit into the hearts of your disciples and increased the immeasurable love of God in their souls. May you be blessed and praised and glorious forever, my Lord Jesus, who are seated in the glory of your divinity on your throne in the kingdom of heaven, yet living in your human nature with all the holy members which you derived from the flesh of the Virgin. Thus you will come in the day of judgment to judge the souls of the living and the dead. You who live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit forever and ever. Amen.